Mr. Speaker, the fall of Constantinople in 1453 marked the end of the Byzantine Empire and began a period of Ottoman control over southeastern Europe, including Greece and Cyprus. Over time, there were several Greek uprisings against Ottoman control, and although they were unsuccessful, the dream of a free and independent Greece carried on. After 350 years of Ottoman control, a plan to rebel in the Peloponnese, the Danube, and Constantinople itself was ready and set for March 25, 1821. This sparked the beginning of the Greek War of Independence, and the desire to live free inspired further revolts in Crete, Macedonia, and central Greece. In 1827, Britain, Russia, and France intervened to support the fight for independence. And at the Battle of Navarino, these allied forces ended Ottoman domination of the Aegean, and the Kingdom of Greece was established in 1832. Mr. Speaker, it gives me great honor and privilege to stand in the Assembly today to commemorate 200 years of Greek independence. To mark this special occasion, I've had the privilege of working with fellow Greek-Canadian politicians from across party lines to coordinate efforts on this important day. Today, Mr. Speaker, you will see the blue and white colors of Greece shine across the world as well, right here at home in the city of Calgary and the city of Edmonton. Both will fly the Greek flag outside City Hall, as will many other Canadian cities. In Australia, the Sydney Opera House will display blue and white colors. A 1,500 square foot Greek flag will be flown in Johannesburg. In the United States, the Los Angeles International LAX sign and Santa Monica Pier's Pacific Wheel will be lit up in blue, as will the CN Tower, Niagara Falls, Edmonton's high-level bridge, and other important landmarks. Mr. Speaker, I hope all members of the Assembly will join me in wishing Greeks here in Alberta and around the world a happy Independence Day and bicentennial.
Here, here.